one, time to get into it. NBA action on 2K Sports. And in our matchup tonight, we'll see the Los Angeles Lakers going up against the Golden State Warriors here in Chase Center. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. DA will join us tonight on the sideline. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Andrew Wiggins, in his eighth season, was named an All-Star starter. That's the second longest wait ever after Kyle Lowry. Wiggins said, in Golden State, I'm around greatness, and those guys believe in me. Offensively, they trust me with the ball, and defensively, I guard the other team's best player. That right there is motivating. Kevin?
Indeed it is. Thank you, DA. And now the Lakers starting group. They'll go small with LeBron at the four and Davis at the five. Then it's Rui Hachimura. And there's D'Angelo Russell, and it's Reeves in at the shooting guard. And for the Warriors, on the wings, Thompson and Wiggins. The pairing up front, it's Green and Looney. And it's Poole in at the one. GA with their fourth title, the combination of Steph, Clay, and Draymond Green, the single most successful trio in the last half century in the NBA.
And some would argue the best trio of all time, the most wins in the finals ever by a trio who've each made an all-NBA team.
Now, Poole, after LeBron's three-pointer that didn't go. The three. And it's Russell with the rebound. And so it's Russell with it. He brings it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. LeBron kicks to Russell. Back to James. Clock at six. From deep. Davis, the pass to Russell. No good from outside. First quarter of play. 1 minute played. Passes it to Thompson. Shoots over Hachimura. And Thompson gets it to go. Thompson's got the scoreboard going with his first points of the night for the Warriors. Now Russell. As you can see from his numbers, he's been a key component in their offense. He's averaging almost 18 points a game. James against Green. Launches it. A shot off that time. And it's the Warriors taking it the other way.
Yeah, scoreless here early after their first four shots. They right now are searching for a bucket.
And now, Greg, that we're into the meat of the season, are you seeing any emerging trends out there?
For a few years, the trend had been guys shooting from farther and farther out. But, Kevin, I think we're seeing a return of the big man, a more concerted effort to attack the interior.
That free throw, no good. One of my favorite eras in NBA history, Clark, the 80s Showtime Lakers.
Man, I played against those guys. Thankfully, it was just twice a year because we were in the Eastern Conference. But those dudes were unbelievable. Magic running the point. Kareem still playing at a high level down low. Worthy finding his stride and finishing the break. They didn't just win titles. Showtime had a flavor that was fun to watch if you weren't being run out of the building by them.
And it's the Warriors' ball. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
Well, I felt like they were never on the same page defensively in that one. Gave up way too many easy shots.
And, you know, that's all about effort, and I'm sure their coach let them have it for the lack thereof.
Pass to Davis. Over Green, and Davis gets it to go.
Davis, a real mismatch inside because of his skill, size, and strength.
Poole, bounce pass. Looney finds Thompson. Back to Looney. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Poole against Russell. Davis with a screen on Poole. Pass to Hachimura. Now here is Davis. Over Looney. And misses it off the right side of the rim. The Warriors have gone 2 of 5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. And the pass to Wiggins. Thompson in the corner. Cranes it from beyond the arc. Thompson's got his second bucket tonight.
I really believe we can go ahead now and lock Klay Thompson in on the short list of the greatest pull-up shooters in the NBA. And we might be talking the all-time list here.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Russell. Let's see the stat sheet here for Anthony Davis. And so Green will bring it up for the Warriors. It's a three-point game. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played. Over in the corner, Poole. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And a miss there on the triple. Lakers trail by 3. Pass to Reeves. Back to Russell. To the inside, Davis. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. They came away with the victory in their last meeting, which, by the way, was also in this building.
Well, last time out, they got the win in large part because of the play of their bench, and they provided a lot of the scoring punch.
Yeah, and you know what? I expect them to go deep into the bench again tonight to give those guys on the bench a chance to have an expanded role, but also to give those starters some rest.
And here is Los Angeles now. The Warriors making the shot. And the Lakers decide to take their first time out here. And the Warriors with a completely new 5 on the floor. Some changes for the Lakers. .125 left in the first quarter. Now here's Schroeder. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game. And the Lakers with another miss.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
Payton against Beasley. Payton outside. Back to DiVincenzo. Shot clock at 6. And Bamba pulls it down. Lakers trail by 5. Pass to Schroeder. There's 39 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Vanderbilt, a screen on DiVincenzo. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Well, that's just an intelligent play call by Schroeder there, using the pick to get himself a good look.
There's 31 seconds left in the first quarter. Payton kicks to Green. To the middle. Here's DiVincenzo. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Here's Beasley. Tipped away. Lets the 3 fly. And the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. And we've reached the end of the first quarter. The Warriors on top, leading by 5. Live from Chase Center, you're watching 2K Sports. And if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And the Warriors, guys, what jumps out to you in this game, stats-wise?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, you look at the energy, the effort defensively, they put it all out there in that opening quarter.
Warriors leading by five. So on the floor for the Lakers to start this second quarter. Beasley is out there with Dennis Schroeder. Then it's LeBron James. Then there's Mohamed Bamba. And it's Walker in at the three spot.
And, you know, for a big man, I think Green is one of the better dime droppers in the league. I mean, he's a true point forward who has excellent vision and sees the floor well.
And here is James. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
And as good as Draymond Green has been on the floor, this guy will be an all-time broadcaster, already a popular podcast. Great TV studio appearances as well.
Now, Poole. Following the miss by Malik Beasley from deep. Poole, the pass to Green. Down low, here's Kuminga. And Kuminga throws it down.
The finish was nice, but the setup was better.
Yeah, G.A., the pick working to full effect before the stuff.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look. And that's exactly how you draw it up.
Here's Beasley. The Warriors making the shot. No good from the wing. And Draymond Green, the next broadcasting star. You've watched his work. Why is that?
And, Kevin, I think his basketball IQ is incredible. And we see that when he plays. But he can also vocalize it to the audience. And, of course, Draymond is not afraid to say what he thinks.
And now the latest from our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. The Lakers are, of course, one of the league's storied franchises. And Magic Johnson was asked recently if they have the best all-time collection of players. He says, it's not even close. Outside of Bill, we have all the dominant closers. Kobe, Jerry, LeBron now, Worthy. Come on now, it's just too many Lakers. Kevin, back to you.
He's got a point, David, and we thank you for your report. Lakers trail by seven.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Pass to Walker. Fires from deep. Warriors with the rebound.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Now, here's Poole. 38 points for him last game against Portland. Here's Green. 2 points. That one goes. Green's got the lead up to nine now for the Warriors.
You have to love the unselfishness on display there. Excellent passing.
And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. James looking around. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
That is the savvy of LeBron on display. Doesn't just convert, but draws the foul and has the chance to tack another one on his point total.
Different look here for the Warriors. Kevon Looney is checked in for Green. Wiggins comes in for Kuminga. Klay Thompson is checked in for Dante DiVincenzo. And it's Ty Jerome in for Jordan Poole. Well, Clark, here's an interesting stat trend of the 2022 season. More shots are taken from three-point range, but fewer makes on average per shot.
Yeah, the volume has gone up, but the makes have not. You know, more teams are launching triples, and more defenses, quite honestly, Kevin, are focused on challenging those shots. Not surprising to see the numbers trending in the direction you mentioned.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Davis. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And that's foul number two. And maybe you don't sit him at this point, but you really have to be careful to not pick up another before half.
3 minutes of action so far in the second quarter. There's the pick. Right wing, three-pointer. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. Four straight field goals have been made off an assist.
Green passes to Jerome. The best, the best, the best. 6 to shoot. Now the pass to Looney. Going inside.
He's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Insane dunk.
And now they're starting to rub it in. Build up a lead, and here we go, baby. It is showtime.
And why not? A little salt in the wound. The more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys reeling and on the ropes.
Ray, here's a classic NBA question. Who's been the best franchise in league history? Celtics or the Lakers?
Come on, Kevin. You are putting me on the spot. But I'd go with the Lakers. More superstars over the years. And I think that 2000s run with Kobe and company, that put them ahead in my estimation.
Lakers trail by 11. Loads it up for Davis. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
There's no stopping that. AD is too long and strong to bother that alley-oop.
.141 left to play here in the half. Here's Jerome. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. Davis with it. Now Green defending. James wide open. They grab their own miss. Davis on the follow.
A really strong second quarter in terms of scoring the basketball.
Here's Jerome. He's guarded by Russell. Thompson outside. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Thompson's got 8 points.
And they've done a great job knocking down those long-range shots here in the second, shooting just over 40% from downtown.
Outside, Russell. And it's Looney with the rebound. Looney's got 5 rebounds tonight. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
These little nuances like the pump fake, developing aspects of Wiggins' expanding game.
It's his first trip to the line. And that one misses.
You know, it's interesting. Some people say Wiggins should play meaner, but to me, the most important thing is that he improves his overall game every year.
Lamb, he's checked in for the Warriors. Gary Payton comes in for Klay Thompson. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Vanderbilt's checked in. And he's good on the second. 43 seconds left to play in the first half. Here's Russell. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
And now in the final year of his contract, D'Angelo Russell trying to get back to that all-star level and the promise that got him that last 4-year deal.
He's off on the first.
You know, Russell's known for his scoring ability, but I like the fact that he's eager and hungry to continue to improve.
He hits the second from the line. Warriors leading by 10. We've got 28 seconds left in the first half. Looney, nice pass, led him to the rack perfectly for the layup. Looney's got 6.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Russell feeling it out a bit. To the paint, here's Davis, and finished off by Davis.
Exactly what you want from your point guard. Nice dime to the open teammate by Russell.
Here's Wiggins. And so it's the Golden State Warriors with a 10-point lead. Some breathing room heading into the break. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. Steve, a good rhythm for you in the first half. What do you like most about how your team's competing?
Just like the ball movement, you know, the drive and kick. Our guys have played really well together. Just trying to move the ball, get a great shot.
We'll see if you can keep the ball flying around as we continue. Thanks. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
Hey, folks, happy you joined us. The action tonight, a bit wild and a big deficit now for the Los Angeles Lakers.
Ice cold, frigid from beyond the arc. The question is now, can they shake it off and get back in the groove? Another option is compensate by going to the rim.
Okay, time to discuss the first half of this one. Specifically, which guys are leading the charge for their teams?
Well, this is what I like to see. None of this is mamby-pamby little man play. I want to see the big guys battle it out.
Same here, big fella. Enough small ball. Let's move some furniture, and let's have you stop saying namby-pamby. Thanks for joining us. Now let's toss it to Kevin Harlan for the start of the second half.
And if you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books, one half to go. Klay Thompson with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
And you know what? It helped that they had a few guys with very hot hands on the perimeter, too.
We'll see Wiggins and Green play in the forward spots. The guard spots filled by Poole and Thompson. And it's Looney in at the center locking down the middle. That's Steve Kerr's five as we get into the second half. And the Lakers with possession here. After the miss from Klay Thompson. That one's in there. The Warrior lead is cut to just 7 points in the basket from Russell.
You know, you look at Russell and the green light is always on from there for him. And he shoots it with confidence.
Thompson outside. Ring shot on the way. And the jumper falls for him. 10 points for Klay Thompson.
Well, he's cooking with grease. He's got things flaming up, looking for an opportunity every time down the floor when he's that hot.
And here is Los Angeles now. Passes it to Reeves. LeBron James on the wing, guarded by Green. And it's slammed in by Davis.
Yeah, you know, LeBron is already top 10 in career assists, okay? And he's also continuing to rack up the dimes and climbing just about every all-time chart there is in the NBA.
Warriors leading by 7. And here in the second half of play, we're just over a minute in. Thompson from long range. No good on the shot, so the Lakers will take it the other way. Green against James. Davis setting the pick for LeBron. They get it back. Davis kicks to LeBron. Off target from three-point range.
He's been ice cold tonight. You know, you look at the scoreboard guys, they really could have used this contribution.
And it's Wiggins with the jam.
Rising above the rim, Wiggins encounters very few defenders who can meet him up at that apex.
And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Davis finds Hachimura. Driving inside. That one's not going to go. Wiggins with some nice D. Pass to Thompson. Fires the three. And right on through for another basket. He's got 5 made on 5 of 9 shooting.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first 3 of the half, there might be more in store.
And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's going to be on Andrew Wiggins.
There are very few that can handle and battle with Davis inside. I mean, he's got really tremendous strength and agility and a nice touch.
And the first one at the line is good.
And looking at Anthony Davis, a huge part of this team.
Sure is. I mean, along with every team he's been on. This is a superstar player. I mean, no question about that. He can headline a roster full of superstars. Not much on the floor that AD can't do.
Looking at who's out there now for the Warriors. Jamichael Green, he's checked in for Kevon Looney. Kuminga comes in for Draymond Green. And it's Dante DiVincenzo in for Wiggins.
Well, he's certainly been on target with the free throws. Such an advantage when your bigs can knock them down from the line.
Thompson inside, guarded by Walker. And good that time. Thompson's got the lead up to 12 now for the Warriors.
And he is really in a zone right now, playing and scoring with confidence.
And that was another look at the fantastic Mobile One drive that happened a moment ago.
And trying to extend this lead, no better way than playing north and south, getting after it.
Schroeder with the ball. Kuminga picks him up. Tips it up. Davis on the follow. Davis has got 14.
And the shooting has really been there for him today, but he may have to take it upon himself to continue to carry this team and try and get out of this hole.
Now here's DiVincenzo. The shot by Thompson, no good. Beasley dishes to Davis. Schroeder surveying the floor. Back to Davis. Five to shoot. Fades away and sinks the tough shot. Davis has got it back down to within single digits for the Lakers. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Poole with it. And he can certainly fill it up when they need him to. He's averaging almost 21 points a game. Green kicks to Poole. And Bamba pulls it down.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
Davis, the pass to Bamba. Schroeder outside. He feeds it to Davis. Over Kuminga. And it's Davis missing.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
Pass to Poole. On the wing, Thompson. Money from the wing. Thompson's got 9 points now in the quarter.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Now, here's Bamba. No points in the game yet for him. The pass to Davis. Shoots over Kuminga. That one's in there. The Warrior lead is cut down to just 8 points with the bucket from Davis.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Here's Poole. Green finds Thompson. And here is DiVincenzo, covered by Beasley. DiVincenzo gets the bucket.
Outstanding focus from Dante DiVincenzo, not allowing a bump to throw him off his shot there. Good concentration.
Davis with a screen on Poole. And it's Schroeder missing. Warriors leading by 10. 6 second difference between the shot and game clock. DiVincenzo kicks to Poole. And he uses the glass on the layup. Poole's got his second basket of the night.
Good find that time by DiVincenzo. An unselfish player, always looking to make the extra pass.
Good on the shot. There's 10 seconds left to play here in the third. Poole on the wing. Offline with his three. Klay Thompson has been leading the charge for the Golden State Warriors. He finishes with 9 points in the quarter. The D is having all sorts of problems with him. And we'll be back with you shortly. While we have the chance now, folks, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant read of the defense. I mean, it was also excellent anticipation of the movement of his teammates before the pass. Just great harmony on all sides.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth and final quarter. And so it's Hachimura who brings up the ball for Los Angeles. Trailing by 10. Taking a look at Los Angeles. LeBron James is out there with Jared Vanderbilt. And there's D'Angelo Russell. Then it's Rui Hachimura. And it's Reeves in at the two-guard spot. Now here's DiVincenzo. After LeBron James's miss. Passes to Wiggins. And it's Wiggins with the jam.
Wiggins just staying with it, refusing to let the defense get the better of him there.
So it's the Lakers now. James outside. Over Green. The shot, no good. The Warriors go the other way with it. Pass to DiVincenzo. Goes up on the block. Lakers with the rebound. We've played just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter. Back to Hachimura. And stolen by Wiggins. Pass to DiVincenzo. And here's Looney. The dish to Wiggins. Payton with the screen for Wiggins. The shot from the low post is good. Wiggins has got the lead up to 14 now for the Warriors.
Tell you what, for a small forward, Wiggins is strong inside, I mean, and only growing in confidence, too. That's scary for the opposition. Watch out now. When this guy gets into a rhythm, it is something to behold.
The Warriors have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. DiVincenzo finds Wiggins. They set the pick. Inside, here's Looney. That falls. Nice feed that time from Wiggins. Wiggins has got his third assist on the night. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. James outside. James throws it down.
How many times have we seen that? I mean, LeBron going right through and into the defense and finds a way to power through the contact as if he hasn't even been hit.
Warriors leading by 12. There's the pass to Looney. Outside, Green. To the paint. Here's Wiggins. And Wiggins throws it down.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat.
Now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
Lakers shooting 43% from the field. LeBron passes to Vanderbilt. To the middle. Here's Russell. And the slam dunk by Russell.
How about that dunk? I mean, you don't see that every game, but Russell looks to flush when the chance is there.
Here's DiVincenzo. Wiggins outside. Shoots over Hachimura. And the Warriors tack on two more.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
I tell you what, it reminds me of one of my college coaches who used to say, "That ain't gonna get it done. That's 5 straight baskets in the paint now."
Passes it to DiVincenzo. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Shot clock at 5. To the inside. The shot by Looney, no good. Lakers trail by 14. Here's Hachimura. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. It's going to be on Andrew Wiggins.
And when Hachimura is looking to score, it sometimes forces the D to get aggressive. Love the energy.
The first one falls. Klay Thompson is checked in for the Warriors. Poole comes in for Dante DiVincenzo. And Anthony Davis is checked in for the Lakers. Hachimura hits them both. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Here's LeBron. Green with the block.
Green takes great pride in his defense now. He loves denying shots at the rim and playing bigger than his 6'8 frame would lead you to believe. You know, with his handles, he excels at tricking up the defense and getting the good looks he wants.
Thompson surveying the floor. Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
A relentless effort from Klay Thompson. He gets the foul and pushes right through for an and one.
In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Warriors.
I'm in love with how they're moving the basketball all game long, and also their ability to move without the ball. That style just makes it so difficult to defend.
The other thing they've done is they have not shied away from the mid-range game. I mean, plenty of points coming their way off of jump shot opportunities. I like that.
Greg, we know that Klay Thompson had 941 days between NBA games because of those injuries. But he was using that experience away for good.
And Klay announcing with that his family foundation would have a 941-day initiative. Programs to help workers who have suffered career setbacks. Thompson helping others with their comeback.
.137 left in the fourth quarter. Now Russell. Davis with a screen on Poole. Here's Russell. Trying to get open as Davis. And Davis throws it down.
Davis using that athleticism to battle it out on the glass. From in that tight, hard to stop AD.
.124 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And it's Thompson with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Warriors. Pass to Poole. Green with a screen on Russell. Poole with it. He's picked up by LeBron. And Davis sends it back.
Not only does Davis have great skill, but he is tremendously agile. He can get shots from just about anywhere on the court.
And so only one team answered the bell tonight, guys. Not a monster blowout by any means, but still a double-digit victory for the Warriors.
Fewer miscues made the difference.
Yeah, I mean, a great all-around effort. Not only did they minimize their turnovers, but kept the pressure up on D, forcing the other team to commit turnovers.
And so it'll boost this year's win total for them to 29. And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Klay Thompson.
Boy, he was absolutely relentless at the offensive end, guys. Smelled blood and went for it.
Here's Russell following the basket by Andrew Wiggins. Back to Russell. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a 3-point play chance for him.
Tremendous balance by Russell. Takes on contact, finishes the play. We'll see if he can get the and one at the line.
Free throw good, Russell. There's 21 seconds left in the fourth. The clock now can just run out for the Warriors. Here's Jerome. So we see the Warriors taking the game here. Some good moments throughout this one, but they had the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Hey, thanks very much, Clay. You had it going tonight. Now, when you are that hot, what are you trying to do on the court?
Took a couple bad shots, a couple heat checks, but they went in tonight, fortunately. When you got the hot hand, you're just looking for that little ounce of space, because all you need is an inch or two, and that thing's just flicking off your wrist so easy, and it just happened to be one of those nights.
That leads to one of those wins for your team, man. Thanks very much. Back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA on 2K Sports. As New Balance presents our Player of the Game, Klay Thompson.